Hi all, this is Sammy from AvidCNC, and I have a quick pro tip video all about how to set up and use the manual tool change feature in Mach 4 with AvidCNC machines. The M6 procedure provided with the AvidCNC Mach 4 profile enables manual tool changes when your CAN post-processor outputs M6 tool changes. This video is supplementary to the Mach 4 user guide available in our written instructions online, and we have linked that in the description below. There's an option to set up an MTC or manual tool change location. This can be used as a quick way to move the machine to a more convenient location to change the tool. It's necessary to have a Z-axis homing sensor in order to use this feature. Note that it's not necessary to set up an MTC location. Alternatively, you can drive the machine using your arrow keys to a convenient location to change the tool. To set up your MTC location, first home your machine. Move your machine to the location you would like to perform your manual tool changes. Then click Set MTC Location. A message box will display your new MTC location in machine coordinates. Great, now you've set your MTC location. We'll set up our material and set up our XYZ work offset using our AutoZ and corner finding touch plate. Once you have your first tool loaded and ready to go ahead and load your G-code. Let's read through our G-code to get familiar with some of the notes and codes here. We can see the title name of our G-code file at the top. On line 3, you can see a note that says, "For AvidCNC machines, post-processor version 1.3. You'll need to update to version 1.3 or later of the AvidCNC post-processor for Vectric to output an M6 code for every toolpath. I've linked a tutorial on how to update and install your post-processor in the description below. A little further down, we can see a list of tools used in this file and their assigned tool numbers. To learn more about how to assign tool numbers in Vectric's programs, we also have a tutorial on this linked below. Here you can see the T1M6 code indicating that tool 1 needs to be installed in the spindle. This will only pause if the current tool on the tool change tab is different than the tool called for in the M6 command. If we scroll down to where the second tool path begins, there is a T2M6 command. The program will pause for a tool change to tool 2. In this case, it's a half inch end mill. Great, after you've run through the 10-step cycle start checklist, go ahead and click Cycle Start. When you encounter a tool change command in your program that specifies a tool number different than your current tool, the Tool Change tab will display the required tool number for the tool change. In this example, the G-code program was started with tool 1 as the current tool. When the program reaches the command M6T2, it's requesting a tool change to number 2. You can now use the Go to MTC Location button to move the machine to your previously saved MTC location. Alternatively, you can jog the machine to a desired spot for the tool change. Take caution to ensure that the machine has a clear path to move to this location. Go ahead and perform your tool change. The G-code window will display the tool information. Confirm that you have inserted the correct tool for T2. Then then use the Auto Z touch plate to zero the Z axis for T2. There are two ways to resume the G-code program after completing the tool change. First, we have the Resume G-code button. This button is enabled after the program encounters a tool change command. When we use this to resume the G-code, the Z-axis will move to a safe clearance height before continuing with the program. We also have the Cycle Start G-code button. Take note that using the Cycle Start button will resume the program without performing a preceding move to a safe Z height. That's how you perform a manual tool change in Mach 4 with Avid CNC machines. Thanks all for watching, and we can't wait to see what you make. I'll see you in the shop.